tell me about your most memorable family vacations.
you got a good one.
No. I mean, my favorite scene is probably, I love the whole ending, the way it's come together. It's really fun and big and it's a giant spectacle. And actually, I think for family vacations, it's kind of a more of a heartbreaking one, where when my kids were younger, I was like their best friend. You know, especially with my son, we'd always play together, I was his playmate. And then as he was going older, we went to Hawaii, and there were some other families which were there with kids his age. And then all of a sudden, I'm like, you know, ready, because this is like my time to spend, you know, every day with them, 24 hours. And he goes, no, Dad, I'm gonna go play with my friends.
Yeah.
And he kind of broke up with me. And it was really hard to, and it was like a big transition in my parental life where I realized, right, I'm not the friend, I'm not the dad.
That's happening in
my life.
He asked 11. He just wants to sleep over at his friend's house all the time.
That's like, sorry.
I think my favorite movie is any. I'm excited to see the scenes with Drek are like romantic scenes. And then I think a family vacation. I grew up in Ohio, and my dad was always trying to like get the cheapest vacation going that he possibly could. So I remember in particular there was a ski resort in Pennsylvania in a place called, I think it was called Blue Knobs, Pennsylvania. And we would go there. We would go there in the summer. We took a road trip in the summer in a ski lodge. And he thought it was hilarious. There's a picture of all of us on a you know, what are the things that you all get in?
Ski lift.
Yeah. A grounded ski lift. In the middle of the summer, like all of us sitting there so annoyed. And he thought it was so charming and hilarious. And I think the hotel rooms were probably like $30 a night. off season. And we all, of course, thought Blue Knobs was a hilarious name for a ski resort.
Right?
Because we're so mature.
I think my favorite scene would be between Mavis and Dracula when she kind of has to let go of her dad, because it's ironic to me, I'm in the opposite end of the spectrum, where it's having my family be so close and then me doing my own thing, and then the older I get, the more I want to take care of them or think I have a right to have an opinion, and that's kind of hard, I think, for a kid, for a daughter. I found that very sweet, because she wants the best but doesn't want to lose her dad. Oh, and I never went on vacations with my dad. We would drive to San Antonio for the San Antonio Spurs game, so that was
that's a vacation.
That was. Yeah. I loved it. So I got to see where.
That is not a vacation.
I really like basketball, and then I got to see the river where Selena Quintanilla, you know who she is.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you though?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Just checking. Anyhow, there's a famous scene that's fine. I go there.
Well, no one cares what I think after all that. I like gremlins, so the gremlin scene. And then we would go to the beach. Let's just go, let's move on.
From Mommy Blog Expert. So this is more of a question for Andy and Selena as well. So you were mentioning about the father-daughter relationship. So as we see that relationship evolve between Mavis and Dracula, once, you know, Dracula zings with Erica, it kind of gets, like, concerning, and she's worried for him. So what message do you think that Mavis is trying to tell with regards to the father-daughter connection? And how did you get that inspiration to, like, you know, embody that between the father-daughter and the family?
I know.
I feel like it's for you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Both.
I think what Mavis is trying to do is be overprotective. I feel that from both ends, from parents and from children. So I find that dynamic is really interesting to me. I think everyone's walked through it, especially a daughter and a father. I think there's something really important, because it's the first man in your life, essentially. It's the first man you love. So it means a lot, and I think for Mavis, that's all she had. And I think that was beautiful. So I relate to that, just because I come from a separated family, and moved from Texas to LA, so yeah, I guess it's just, I sympathize with it.
Hi, my name is Angela with Queen V Latina. I have three little girls that are watching you live, Lali, Sol, and Maya.
Hi,
and
Maya.
That is a great question. I love being in my pajamas.
Yes.
And I love not having anybody look at me, so that's really fun. The difference when I am on screen, I gotta eat better, and I've gotta act with my face, which apparently I have a very expressionful face. I don't know what that means, but my nana always says that. Yeah, I think the difference is pretty great. You get to relax more in one, and the other you're having fun and you're on camera. Yeah. Love you guys.
Julie Nichols from Twin University. First of all, I want to know the scenes with the werewolves dropping off their kids at the play place on the ship. Were you following me and my husband and our twins with a hidden camera? Because I very much related to that scene. But besides that, I was actually really surprised and delighted at the near the end of the film with the whole theme of, you know, how we are really all the same deep down, and that it's so important to, you know, not, you know, disclude somebody or want to hurt someone because of who they are and in this climate that we are in today. Could you please speak to that?
I mean, yeah, I mean, we never want to be too heavy-handed, you know, because I don't want to, you know, talk down to anybody. But I think it's part of the, you know, the franchise of Hotel Transylvania that it's always about acceptance, you know. And so I think for this one, it was kind of the reversal of where there's people who hate monsters, and we know they hate monsters. And then as Erica's trying to kill Dracula, she's kind of realizing what an amazing person he is, and that he's actually just as human as she is. So it was our kind of subtle, but you know, sometimes when you're more subtle, it's bigger, plays bigger and better. And so that was kind of the goal.
Thank you.
Yes. Hi, Susie from Happy Miss Moments. I just wanted to know, were there any Easter eggs in this movie?
Easter eggs.
Are you allowed to say if there are?
I don't know what that means.
It's like clues?
Surprises.
No, there's little homages to stuff that have inspired me through my career, like actually the shoes that Drac is wearing. Are the shoes from the vacation movies?
Yes.
The white leather
kind
of loafers.
Really?
Yeah. Because that's one of my
awesome.
Favorite.
I love that.
And so. so that's. But yeah, usually there's not a lot more
okay.
of that type of things.
Okay.
Things.
That's awesome.
Anything like little homages to the first couple films? Yeah.
No, no.
Well, the characters have the same faces.
Man,
yeah.
That's great they carry that through. Does this one up? Yeah,
right.
Hi, my name is Tegan, and my question is, what is your favorite positive song from the movie at the end, and what's another song that makes you happy?
Catherine, what's a song that makes you happy?
Oh, you know, my daughter was just in West Side Story. Oh, and any song from that musical makes me happy. Makes me want to cry. I love that musical so much.
So it's okay.
It's the best. Neck of tears. Is, you know that expression? When you cry so hard, you have tears on your neck. Neck tears.
I love all the music from the movie, but a song that makes me really, really happy is This Is Me from The Greatest Showman.
Yeah.
I don't care what mood I'm in or who said who or what just happened, it makes me so happy and it makes me feel good about who I am, and it's amazing to blast in your car.
Do you sing along when you listen to it?
Very loudly.
Yeah. I had a hunch. Gandhi, do you have a song that makes you happy, man?
It's an odd one, but it's Moonlight Feels Right by Starbucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's something about it that it just, whenever I'm stressed or sad, I play it, and it's just happy. I don't know. It's weird.
Nice.
Yeah.
How about you?
Yourself?
You know, the Knight Rider theme song? It was a television show in the 80s about a car that could talk. Well, I'm not here now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's a very synth-heavy theme, and yeah, it makes me want to just bug out and just, like, just go off, you know?
Yeah.
Just live it.
Yeah.
And anyway, so you can check that out on YouTube.
Kara, we have two questions from our people, Facebook viewers.
Yay.
One is from Edward Sanchez, and he wants to know what characteristics you share with your characters. If any.
I mean, looking at my character, I can't see any similarities. Other than
I
me.
Can.
Don't say no. Don't you say no. Don't you say no.
My hair is short, definitely, physical-wise, but I can be a bit much sometimes. I think she always likes to take care of everybody, and yeah, she's kind of just all over the place. Being unconventional, I relate to that.
Mm. I'd say I'm a little bit of I've got a touch of OCG, and favorite co-wit as well. I like being a cruise director, would be in my, I would say.
And then, this is...
real quick. You also provide a voice. I don't know if you want to, not that you would identify with the character's voice, but.
Well, I do voice Blobby, and I do feel jiggly. I move sometimes, so there's some other characters.
Can you
there.
Give us a little taste of Blobby?
a little taste.
It's, I don't want to, you know.
Yeah! Exclusive.
And then there was a question from Catherine Ong for Selena, and she wanted to know if your Gracie, I believe, is your sister, if she's seen any of the films.
Oh, that's so sweet. Yes, actually, she's seen all of them, and she'll be seeing this one as well. She's my little angel. I love her so much.
Unfortunately, that's all we have time for, but I have to thank the cast, and thank you so much for being here.
Thank you!
The movie comes out July 13th. And
Friday 13th.
Yes, and if you want to see it early, there's Amazon is doing a special set of early screenings, so check that out. Find out where they are near you. Anything else? Any other closing comments?
No, thank you.
Thank you.
Can you just sit tight for 1 second, please?
In Kansas, right? And then when, so you can imagine in the audience, there was no Latin representation.
What?
And